It is the start of July, and a lot of beekeepers right now are worried about nectar dearth. Dearth is when there ain't no nectar and the bees don't have any food and they can actually starve to death. I'm very lucky because there's a native species of tree in my area that's blooming right now in July, which is crazy because most trees bloom, you know, April, May, early June. But this tree is very special, native species, makes one of the most desirable honeys in America too, so that ain't so bad. I'm gonna go show you that tree. It's a little hard to get to. I actually have several on my property. They're about 30 to 40 feet tall. I never really noticed them until I started beekeeping. That's something about beekeeping. If you're a beekeeper long enough, you're also going to become a botanist. I've always loved plants and IDing trees and such. But being a beekeeper, I really keep my eyes out learning more and more. If there's flowers blooming, that means that the bees are fed, basically. So that's very important to me. Bees, luckily, for the most part, they are a generalist feeder. There's certain flowers they just won't go to, but in general, there's lots of different pollen and nectar sources that the bees will use for their honey. So let's go ahead and see what this magic tree is. Any guesses? You're wrong. Let me show you. I'm actually curious. As I was filming, one of our chickens was in this old tire, and I wonder if she laid an egg, so who knows? It's like maybe she was just pecking and foraging. Hey, donkey buddy. We still talk about what we're gonna name this guy. I think we settled on Wyatt for his name. He's a good guy, though. Hey, Wyatt. Hey, buddy. So, a lot of our property has some great bee trees. There's a decent amount of maple. No giant maples, although at the very top of our property, which is about a mile on a trail, actually, 0.91 miles from the house on a trail. I know that because I used Google Maps and walked it. There's a bunch of maples at the very top, like big maples. I'm saying like it would take a person's arm to go around them. So decent sized maples. And we have some smaller maples. Those are mainly to get the bees going. I don't get maple honey. It's such an early bloom that I don't really think people make maple honey because the bees are using that honey. But it gets them going. We also have a decent amount of locust. Locust honey is pretty valued. Some of the bigger trees you see are walnuts. As far as I know, bees don't really like walnut trees. We have some massive oak trees way up top. Those are some big, big oak trees. Gigantic mammoths, I would call them. Right on our property line. I mean, they are big. I'm probably going to do a video on the big trees on our property. I'm not saying these are sequoias, but I mean, you know, they're decent size. We also have tulip poplar. I don't see any right in this area, but back in the woods, we got tulip poplar on the edges. Tulip poplar honey is a good honey as well. So we have those trees on our property that bees love. We also got lots of wildflowers blooming. But the tree I'm talking about, you might even be able to see it. It's going to be so hard to see. Right up there, and I'll zoom in a second, that is a sourwood tree. That's right, sourwood. If you ever heard of sourwood honey, some people say it's the best dang honey in America. It's basically northern Florida, Georgia, South Carolina, North Carolina, where I live, maybe parts of Virginia, and that's kind of the sourwood bloom. Tennessee. What's so great about sourwood, it's the only major tree blooming right now. which means it's pretty easy to say, hey, this is sourwood, because there's not a lot else blooming. Whereas all of the other trees have already bloomed, sourwood is right in the middle. I say mid-June to maybe the second week of July is when the sourwood's blooming. And the bloom is, it's a beautiful tree. It kind of feathers out and has these little white, almost, to me, they look like tulip flowers, but they're tiny. So I'm going to zoom in, and then I'm going to shimmy up that tree. That's right, 40 feet up, and I'm going to break off a branch and show you what a sourwood tree looks like up close. Now here is a close-up look at the sourwood leaf and their flower here. There's still a lot of buds. This was really hard to climb 40 feet up to get this flower, so I hope you appreciate it. It's a very feathery flower. It kind of looks like a hand or a bird's wing, maybe. Maybe that's a better way to explain it. Looks like a dove's wing. But this flower is very important to the bees, again, because there's no other tree blooming. A lot of people, I think, that don't know about honeybees think that bees just get, I guess, nectar from wildflowers. But most bees, a major source are their trees, and I hope you learned that in this video. So again, here's a close-up look of the flowers of a sourwood. So the leaf is not descript at all. It would be hard, unless you're really good at identifying trees, to just see this leaf and know, oh, sourwood. But after a while, I think you can learn it. So I'm very, very happy that I have this tree on my property. It's gonna help with sourwood honey production, which is very prized, but also it's going to prevent dearth. There's not a lot of stuff blooming at the, you know, midsummer, really. The month of July is where dearth really happens. So this is a native tree to North Carolina, probably one of the most prized honeys in America. I would say top three. And around here, people go nuts for it. So until next time, keep on beekeeping.